Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome back to the Uncharted Drake's Fortune Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. When we last left off, Elena had just fallen off this rickety bridge. She lost her camera, but we must press on as the action continues.
Can I get down there without dying?
I don't know. I'm gonna say no. I'm gonna walk the old-fashioned way.
I go up this way first.
I'm gonna go down.
Oh!
Because I am reasonably sure there's a treasure over here along the other side of this. I don't know how to get over there, but I know there's a treasure. Oh, this right here.
Great! Look at you! A silver Spanish chalice for all of your silver Spanish drinks. Congratulations, Knight, on becoming a 12 for 60 treasure hunter. For Treasure Hunting Broadcasting International, I am Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell with the daily Treasure Hunter updates.
Only on Game Time. Did I remind you that Howard has an exclusive agreement with Game Time? That was a big net for us here at Jogwheel. That was a big client that we signed. I'm very proud of that, so. You're not going to see Howard Cosell on any other LPs. Let me tell you what. He has signed an exclusive agreement only for Game Time.
Who's this guy?
Hey. I think you got an itch on the back of your head there. Can I scratch it for you? What about you? Can I scratch your itch?
What was this? That was this little alcove. That was a doorway or something.
I get distracted by the easiest things.
Dun 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 dun.
Oh! 20 kills with the West 44! Good job. Now head towards the door.
Didn't mean to rhyme, but there I go. Look at me now. I'm about to blow. There he is! We only have 4 lines of recorded dialogue, so we must repeat them all the time. Shit!
Meanwhile, Nate has a whole bunch of things he can say.
You're mine, asshole!
He's mine, asshole!
Alright, let's hop on the jet ski, Elena.
This river ought to take us right up to the monastery.
Heading upriver to the monastery. Dun, 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 dun. Nate Drake, he's on a jet ski, going up river to the bad guys, know the monastery. Nate Drake is on a jet ski, he's gonna ride the river rapids. Nate Drake, he's on a jet ski with his female friend, yeah. But they're not dating yet, it's just platonic, yeah.
You gotta avoid these giant explosive barrels because, as we all know, when you see a barrel in a video game or a movie, it will usually immediately blow up and hurt you.
Come on, drive.
Come on.
This is a really powerful jet ski. This is a good jet ski right here. You could sell this on Craigslist for a couple grand easy.
Oh, jeez.
Probably should have killed me. But it didn't. So, here we go.
Nate Drake is on a jet ski, dodging oil barrels, yeah.
Where's like, there's no enemies here, so it's kind of, well, there's a couple enemies here and there. Can I shoot them? Is that the West that I just have unlimited ammo with? That's awesome. It seems whatever weapon you were using when you hop on the jet ski is what you get to use on it. And since they can't really expect you to get ammo when you're floating around on the river, you actually seem to have unlimited amounts of ammo, which is pretty boss.
God sakes, Elena, hit the barrel!
There's barrels next to him? Oh, see, I didn't see the barrel. I'm sorry.
Oh! My shins! Ooh, we're in a cave. This is nice.
It feels like I'm some sort of chartered Disney adventure tour or something.
Very la-di-da.
I gotta go up the right side here. Left side looks a little too steep. Although, quite frankly, I don't think a jet ski would be able to do any of this.
But it's a video game!
Oh! Got a little wet there. That's what he said. That's what he did say.
Come on, Jesus, what the fuck? Come on!
Ooh. Oh, yeah. I think we're almost at the terminus of this little jet ski adventure here. This is fun, but I don't know. I feel like they could add something a little different to it. Just kind of dodging and driving around barrels. I will say that jet ski missions are pretty cool, and it's a really good and fresh change of pace from all of the jumping and shooting, so I'm very glad the Uncharted series has other levels where you're not just running and jumping. Because the game would definitely get really old fast. I'm glad they have it, even if dodging oil barrels can feel kind of like a chore and less fun than if you were actually in like a full just hauling ass mode where you're just flying down the river, which I think that would be fun. Kind of like the Jeep level we played a little earlier. We're just like flying through the river and shooting people instead of going really slow and dodging stuff. That's not as fun. That feels like work. Ugh, come on! And by the way, why are there so many oil barrels in the river anyway? Like, is this how they transport them? Is there an oil refinery upstream and then the only way to get them to the shipping boats is just drop them in the river and pick them up when they float downstream? Because if so, that seems like a terrible transportation method. Rethink your delivery scheme, friends. All right, I think we're at the end of this little thing here, but I forget where you disembark. Is it right over here? Yeah, it's a little what looks like a dock here. Cinematic engaged. We are now off the jet ski.
All right?
Yep.
Okay, let's head up to the monastery and see what's going on.
Chapter 13. Sanctuary? Why does it have a question mark? Do we just not know it's a sanctuary? I thought we were supposed to be some history expert. And the legend continues. Can I just bust this open? Busted it open! Oh, jeez, that was the only bullet I had in that gun. Finish him! Also, start him! Because I haven't hit him yet. Jeez, that was embarrassing. I'm sorry you guys saw that. Make it up to you with this kill. Great, I have more bullets now. I feel like there's probably a treasure over here. Maybe over this way? No? No treasures? No treasures? Are there any treasures here? If there's any treasures now, speak now, or forever hold your pieces of gold and or silver. We're running, we're jogging, we're jumping, we're looking for treasure still looking for treasure. There is treasure. It's right there. You see it? It was right there. I knew there was treasure in this area, and now I'm gonna go pick it up. Because if there's anything I like doing more than walking around and jumping, it's picking shit up off the ground. Golden turtle. Wow, look at that. He has a huge oh, I'm sorry, that's his tail. A common mistake for me, Howard Cosell, here at ABC Sports Treasure Hunting International Headquarters. Great job, Nate. That was number 13. Thanks, Howard. Now, back to the game. Oh! That's gonna hurt. It's a good thing he's wearing those Timberlands, though, am I right? He's busting down rusty doors like it's his job. And as far as you're concerned, it is his job. Also, I think there might be another treasure just inside. Anytime the game wants you to obviously advance from point A to B, stop. Because there's a point C in between. And that's where the treasures are. Although, apparently, not in this scenario. Even though there's a little bit of an area to explore next to the stairs, it does seem that this particular juncture is just straightforward, go to the top and advance the game. Because this is the sanctuary?
Would you slow down? One of Eddie's goons could be up ahead.
I thought Elena was
behind.
Come on,
we left those clowns in the dust ages ago. Oh my god.
What's wrong? Is he okay?
That's
disgusting.
He's dead. Oh, I wish I had my camera.
Reminds me of Alfred Molina in Raiders of the Lost Ark.
The Spanish booby-trapped the island to protect their gold?
Makes sense. I would've.
This wasn't made by the Spanish.
Uh-oh.
Take a closer look at the spikes.
It says made in Japan on it.
You have got to be kidding me.
This is from our plane.
Wait, that doesn't make any sense, though. Why would someone set traps like this when their own men are crawling all over the island?
Because they're
stupid. They wouldn't. Something's been here since the trap was sprung.
Something or someone?
Probably a jackal. Was it a jackal?
Do you think
that... Is it a jackal? Is it a jackal?
Hear what?
Oh, sorry, I just farted.
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. We're being watched.
Watched?
How do you infer that? The jungle's making all sorts of noises.
Yeah, you know what? It's probably nothing. Let's just get out of here before we run into whatever's been chewing on this guy.
Okay.
He doesn't have any bite marks. Are you saying there's vampires loose in the area? I don't know if I follow what you're putting down, Nate. I'll be completely honest with you. This reminds me of, like, a scene out of Avatar or some shit. Like, all the vines and stuff grown over. And...
Hey!
Whoa!
Keep your head down! These guys have laser sights!
Come on, would you die already? What the hell is this? Are you T-1000? Bloody hell. Press circle repeatedly to avoid laser targeting. They're still impervious. Or what's the, I guess, pervious? I guess would be the opposite of impervious. They're still completely pervious to just straight up headshots, though, so that's cool. Watch out for the lasers, though, because if they get a clean lock, you are dead in one shot. That is Scaramanga at the other end of that thing. Christopher Lee with the laser sight, and he's going to golden gun you out of existence.
Roman and Navarro can't be far off if they've left their attack dogs at the gate.
Pick up the M4 with 34 bullets. All right, fine. Fine. Ooh, the Desert Eagle with 7 shots. I like it. I like it. I like it a lot. I'm 50. 50 years old. You guys see Jodie Foster's wicked crazy speech at the Golden Globes a few weeks back? Or whenever the hell it happened? Because I don't know when this video is going to get posted. I'm all for her coming out and being like, hey, I'm loud, proud, gay, and, you know, whatever. But her speech didn't even make any sense. It just confused me. Oh, John, your topical commentary on an event that happened a month ago is humorous to me because I don't remember it. Oh, well. It happened recently in my timeline. Oh!
Go in the library secure. Don't let them get to Sullivan.
Yes, sir. They've got the old man working on the east side of the complex.
I don't even know why they brought him along. That son of a bitch can't be trusted.
Here it is, one word again. Go for the guy right there. Nate Drake shooting bad guys, and they're dead now. Bum, 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 bum.
He's here.
You can't let him get a lock. You gotta stay moving. Oh, that was close. Another second, he would have had me. Okay. I haven't seen anybody survive the Desert Eagle before, but there's a first time for everything. Like Tom Brady losing at home in the playoffs after having a lead at halftime. Oh, woe is me. Again, more topical stuff that happened to me just recently, but probably not in your timeline because this video was posted a couple weeks after I recorded it.
Nice.
How many bullets did I have left in the Desert Eagle? 6? I'll keep it. 6? That's 6 kills. But the other gun, I have to get headshots, which is not as easy as it seems. Was there a treasure right there? No, it was just a weapon. Okay, I saw a little glint. A little glint in me eye.
Nate, I've got a bad feeling about...
You have a bad feeling about a lot of things.
Me too. Let's just find Sullivan and get the hell out of here.
Quiet. Too quiet.
Now!
Whoa, what just happened?
Well, they're coming in one way or another. We might as well sing the Nate Drake theme song.
His name is Nate Drake, this is his theme song. He's killing henchmen and climbing platforms. He rides a jet ski and shoots a shotgun to save his girlfriend, whose name is Fisher. He looks for treasure, destroys some ruins with his friend Sully because he loves gold. His name is Nate Drake, and he'll shoot you now. Yeah.
As opposed to shooting to injure? One thing I wish Uncharted did have is, like, some signifier that the guy is dead. Like, in Call of Duty, there's, like, a plus 100 or some stupid thing that shows up on screen when you kill a guy. And that would be really helpful here, because a lot of times I feel like I've killed them, because I've shot them 4 or 5 times, and they're not dead. Because they're wearing some sort of, like, gold-plated bulletproof armor, and I can't destroy them with any normal means. Outside of a bullet to the head, starring Sylvester Stallone, opening theaters nationwide on February 1st. Sorry, I'd go into movie phone every now and then. It's a curse. It's my responsibility. My gift. I go into Spider-Man 1 monologues a lot too. Sorry. You stop dicking around, Nate. I want you to hold it this corner and then get that guy. All right, now let's go up the stairs. Okay, let's not go up the stairs. It seems you have a lot of friends up there. You guys having a Super Bowl party or something? What the fuck's going on? Get the hell out of here. Whoa! I don't think he aimed it at me. He just shot. Got lucky. All right, get out of the circle. Stop. Disengage. Oh, this is good. There was a big shotgun here. I'm going to take that. And I'm also going to take the Desert Eagle. Which I saw around here. Where was it? Desert. Here we go. Desert 5. Alright, so it looks like we have some walls to climb. Because this area... nothing doing right there. But I do think we go back there later. In the meantime... let's do this stuff. Ah, jeez, I fell. That's embarrassing. Climb back up here. Yeah, hint. Climb the wall. All right, here we go. There we go. Okay, just missed it up last time. Whoa! Da-da-da-da-da. It's so convenient that all these things are lined up and perpendicular to each other at precisely the distance needed for me to jump from one to the next. I don't think that one should have worked. I should have fallen. That was like splintery wood. I wouldn't have been able to grip onto that. Timberlands! Built for tough. The only shoe you need to break down rusty doors and desecrate Spanish heritage. Right, this looks like a dead end. And also, I don't think I can jump from anything to anything else. So I'm going to go back this way and see what's down here. Oh, okay, good. I can go through this area. What the hell is that noise? Guess I should fall down and see what it is. What's that? Is that a gun? What's a gun doing in the corner? I don't think I've been over here yet. Alright, okay, this is a door. Alright, I remember this part of the game. Let's go open this giant door up, and then, I guess... come on, open it! Alright, so I can't open the door. The door is unopenable. I wish it would tell you as such, but you just have to assume that you're not doing it good enough. It's, you can't do it at all. What's that? Just giant stack of barrels with explosives. Get out of my house.
Nice job.
Yeah, but what did that do? Oh, now you can come in. And now with Elena's help, maybe I can open this big giant door over here. Is that what? Okay, that's what's happened. Come on, Elena, you can help. Help me out with this thing. Prop it open. Stick a box under there or something.
Here, I'll hold that while you brace the gate open.
All right, good. I think this probably should have been done the other way around.
You ready?
Okay, let it go. Gently.
That seemed like a stupid idea. Thing probably weighs like a few hundred pounds. Way to break your back, mate. All right, so we are in a new area here. It looks scary and frightening, and I don't like it because people are going to be shooting at me. I'm positive. Ooh! Silver toothpick for picking all of your silver tooths. Collected 14 of 60. Congratulations. You are an excellent treasure hunter, Mr. Drake. For ABC Sports / treasure hunting, I am Howard Cosell. Oh, jeez. Come on, stop it. Stop pointing. It's scary when you pointed at me. Dragon sniper. Nice. There's another guy over this way. I know there's more of them around. Where are they shooting at me from?
In the middle of a firefight, we have to stop the video, but unfortunately for now, for me, that'll have to do it for this episode of Game Time. But stay tuned for the next installment, where we finally meet back up with Sully and find out if he's a traitor or not, and solve some more clues and go deeper into this mystery. But until then, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.